this hair look like in the morning.
So I try to do cardio in the morning whenever I have time to increase my TDEE. I ran out of protein powder, so this ready made ones are really a lifesaver. And normally I get this fish snack if I'm feeling snackish because the protein content is very high. Hi Evie. Woo. I finally remembered to charge my microphone, so here's my back and quads day. I normally start off with scapular depressions and then I go straight into the warm-ups.
So the reason why I start off with leg pull-down is because my back is a weak point.
So the reason why I sound so scared is because I haven't used a mic in damn long and I kept mumbling to myself, but it gets better, I promise.
You got 5 reps. That's fine, because 4 is a flaw.
Translation is, I got 5 reps. That's fine, because 4 is the floor. Next, moving on.
But okay, so I haven't filmed in like super long. Like, I haven't spoken into the microphone for super long.
Yes, it's excuses, but well.
So actually, it's quite nerve-wracking speaking into the microphone after so long. So I think this video, I might sound like a nervous bitch.
Yes, you do sound like a nervous bitch, but it's okay.
But it's fine. Okay, just now we got 5 reps, so I dropped the weight. Because I probably won't even be able to get 4. Let's see how many can go on a second set. See, good call to drop the weight. That's 2 working sets.
So I could have cut out all the nervous bitch moments from the video, but I wanted you guys to see that like I do get nervous also, and like I had to build up confidence to speak into the mic in a public gym again.
And like why I like Strength Master is because even the attachments, you have to put it back, otherwise you get fined. So like, I was quite sin, cause I thought today was chest day, but I forgot I'm on a new program. The putting of the weights on the machine is a workout in itself already. Okay, so we did a pull down to target the lats. Now we need something for the mid back. We'll start our set off with 3.5 cookies. So here's 3 cookies. And here's half a cookie. Okay, so why is this more mid back? Is because when you pronate, right, your elbows or your shoulders internal rotate. And it forces your elbows to flare, which forces your shoulder blade to retract, which is what the main function of the mid back is. I swear to God, like I should have continued just using a microphone. Now it's like learning a new skill again. Feel like a noob.
So like normally in these style situations, I will start calling myself out. Like I'll start acknowledging that I'm acting like a bitch, I'm acting scared, so that I don't kind of like invalidate myself. And I tell myself like, it's okay to be nervous. I am nervous, it's okay to be nervous. And that helps me build up confidence, as you guys will later see as the video progresses.
We got like 8.5. So like the people complaining that they have no appetite at all, right? It's because our training intensity is very, very low. Your body doesn't feel like it needs extra calories. That's why it doesn't signal for hunger. So normally if you push your training intensity up, the hunger signaling will go up also. just make sure you hit your protein intake first.
As you can see, after that set, I was more confident. It could be the validation I gave myself. It could be the lightheadedness from the workout. But confidence is not being scared. Confidence is doing stuff despite being scared. Fucking wise.
Okay, so we got eight and a half reps during the previous set. So right now, I'm gonna aim for 6. If I can go for more, then I'll go for more. I don't really have a rep target in mind. Normally, I will overestimate my rep target because I don't want to stop at 6, like when I can do more. Just like close your eyes and do as many as you can. Then just improve from that the next week. So we've done a row from the top for the lats and a row with your elbows flat for the mid back. So the last one will be a row with the elbows close to the body for the upper middle lats. Today we'll try to push for 100. 108.5. Let's rest. So if I manage to hit this weight, this will be a new PR. Cause I've never gone above 90 kg for the seated row before. But it just goes to show that you can still make progress while you're cutting, as long as you keep your protein intake high. Okay, 7 reps, and now a back off set. So the reason why I only do 2 sets for back is because I'm training it twice in my program. So I'll do back and quads, which is today. Then I'll do chest, hands and glutes, day 2. Day 3 will be back again after resting. And then day 4 will be arms. And then I repeat. So in essence, I'm training chest only once every 5-6 days. And back a bit more frequently. But I only do 2 sets for back. Fuck, that was a tough set. So even though I've made a lot of videos on TikTok already, like I still get nervous when I film outside. It's like the thoughts of like, oh, why people think I'm weird? Or is this guy talking to himself? Or this guy think he what influencer, all these thoughts like do come in. But I feel like a lot of people are scared to be uncomfortable. But like most of the time, right, when you're uncomfortable is where you have the most growth. Which is why like I left my previous job also, because like I felt like I was too comfortable there. And I left to do freelance. So now every day is like very stressful, but I also feel like I've grown the most like in the past like 6 months doing freelance than like the 2 years when I was in a commercial gym. Okay, it's been roughly 3 minutes, so I'm gonna start my next set. Trying to aim for 10. I dropped the weight by 1 pin. We'll see how many we can get. So because it's only 2 sets, right, I try to push to like beyond failure. Like as much as possible, I try to do a few partials. Come, let's go. Optimal, bro. So I thought today was hamstring and glutes day. So I wore the wrong shoes to squat. But we'll see how it goes. Anyways, because this is a fourth exercise, I'm not gonna go very heavy on the hex squat. Okay, so the reason why I don't go very heavy on this is because I'm just using this exercise to load my knee and ankle joint and to maintain joint function. I'm not trying to grow my legs anymore. And also because this is the fourth exercise, so I'll be pretty fatigued already. And because this is so technically demanding, like it's very hard to make progress when I put it at the fourth exercise. So the heaviest I've ever gone for a hex squat is like 5 plates. And like because this is the fourth exercise, I expected a drop. But we hit 6. So every time I hit 6 reps, I'm gonna just increase a bit. Okay, you guys can see, but I'm adopting a very narrow stance. The narrower the stance, the less the hip can contribute to the movement, which makes this mostly a quad movement. But the weight feels light. I wish I wore my other shoes. Feet started to cramp. That's done. Joints feel good for the next week. Repeated bout effect. Hey, last exercise, everyone's favorite superset. Leg extension into scissor squat. I'll take off my shoes before the sneakerheads get angry. But like my dunks are quite trash already. So I'm gonna load 80 kg first. With a leg extension, you always want to lean back. Otherwise, you disadvantage the rack fam if you lean forward. Last exercise, let's do this. So I loaded 2 at the bottom range, 2 at the top range, and 2 for 6. 6 in the middle. So that's a total of 100 kg. It goes straight into it. So I'm gonna load the mid-range of the leg extension. Fuck, I finished a lot of the plates. Another 20 kg. Be sure not to hit 10 this set. But you don't do it on purpose. Okay, let's go.
So after the workout, I had this $5.50 Cai Peng.
Done.
This Cai Peng with 2 meat and 1 tofu only cost me $5.50. Okay, so yesterday for groceries, I bought pre-marinated chicken breast, which I'm probably gonna have for dinner later. And I bought lean ground beef, which I'm probably gonna make into burgers for a snack in the evening. So far the cut is going well. I'm down like 2 kgs and I look a lot leaner because of the loss of water weight, the initial loss of water weight. If you like my video, like, share, subscribe. And the next video, I promise, is the rave in KL already. Thank you.